Hi YouTube, hi everyone at home. I'll keep it simple. The idea behind this channel, this video, is to break down the bars, to try to understand what the artist was saying. I know there are a lot of such channels, but the idea is that everybody kind of understands a song from their own perspective and their own opinion. So I'll try to understand each lyrics the way I feel the artist was trying to talk to me, and I'll try to convey my message to you, try to make sure that I catch each bar, each metaphor. I've been listening to hip-hop and rap music since a long time. I love the culture. I love these artists. So this is Marsh by Eminem. It's a part of his new album, Music to be Murdered By. It got dropped 2 weeks back, and let's just listen to it and see what Eminem is trying to say. I've been a big fan of Eminem as a kid, and probably heard all of his albums that inspired me to make music, to write stuff. So if you like something on this channel, maybe these videos or the music that I upload for artists, please don't hesitate to like and subscribe. Let's just get into the track.
My name is Martian. This world, I'm out of it. Because with all this ABC shit, I'm stuck.
So I think the good part over here is that there is a metaphor right in the start. So as Martian, it could be Marsh, it could be Martian, or it could be even Marshall. So it's like Eminem is trying to give us three different ideas from one single line. So I'll not try to break it or pause it so often. Let's just continue.
My name is Martian. This world, I'm out of it.
And the beat is really good.
With all this ABC shit, I'm starting to sound like Alphabet. Ha! I kill me.
With all of this ABCs, I'm trying to sound like Alphabet. So I think what he's trying to say is with new tracks that Eminem keeps releasing, he keeps using so many words, so many new different words, non-repetitive words, that he might be sounding like the alphabet, like everything is being utilized. And then along with that, the another reference in this particular line is Alf a bit. So it's like Alf. Alf was probably a show in Hollywood. I think it was pretty long ago. I have not even watched it. But then I think it's a reference to Alf from Alf, and it's also to elves. So it's just my way. I think it's alphabet. And then what he said, I kill me. I kill me was probably, if you search for it on YouTube, I kill me was a very famous line by Alf. So I think that's the reference over here. Let's just run it back.
This sound like alphabet. Ha! I kill me.
I kill me.
This medicine's counterfeit. I was misled by the sound of it. How am I gonna get turned up on this value shit?
So you can see how the beat came in. The beat was really smooth the way it came in, and in fact Eminem is saying, how can I get turned up on this volume shit? So it's like he's indirectly telling you that how much more loud can he make the bass or the volume of this song. But then if we go a little back, he also talked about a medicine that is counterfeit, like a medicine that can be misused. And then Valium, if you guys don't know, Valium is a drug. So I think this is a reference to Valium also. So turned up is like turned up on Valium, getting high on Valium. Let's just run it again.
Yeah.
Feel like I'm going bonkers, like my toilet's talking. So there was another cartoon show where I think it was called Bonkers, where the toilet talks. So this is a very clever way of referencing that over here. Until now, it's like 22 seconds in the song, and it's already smart the way all these words have been used. It's so many double entendres. Let's just continue.
Bonkers for real, think my toilet's talking. I spill like 40 bottles. I feel sick, your boy is starting to feel like a spoiled carton of milk. Cause it just occurred, my girl's cheating.
Spoiled carton of milk. So if you have a carton of milk that got spoiled, it just happened, it just occurred. But then at the same time, if milk is spoiled, then milk becomes all thick and it becomes yogurt or curd. So I think it's just a curd. So if milk would have been spoiled, it would just be curd. That's it. It just occurred. This is really clever. It's starting to feel like a spoiled carton of milk, cause it just occurred. My girl's cheating, I'm kicking that fucking bitch to the curb. But the word fucking ain't meant to be a descriptive word. The type of bitch she is ain't no adjective, it's a verb. Hope things are snatches, magical, but that's how she attracts men, though. Traps them in a text similar to an actual arachnid or vaginal tarantula or... Vaginal tarantula, I think most of you can relate to that or maybe make sense out of it. We don't need to break that down. Bitchiest ain't no adjective, it's a verb. Hope things are snatches, magical, but that's how she attracts men, though. Traps them in a text similar to an actual arachnid or vaginal tarantula or black widow. In fact, it'll be nothing to throw that little bitch with a capital P out the back window with a black cat. Capital B, he's trying to call out Cardi B over here. So I'm not sure because he has mixed it up into the lyrics. It's a little complicated to exactly understand who he's targeting, but I think this is in reference to Cardi B. A black widow, in fact, it'll be nothing to throw that little bitch with a capital P out the back window with a black Cadillac limo, like a whack demo. What I'm strapped. At the back of the Cadillac limo, like a whack demo. Yeah, so this could be Cardi B over here. Throw that little bitch with a capital P out the back window with a black Cadillac limo, like a whack demo. When I'm strapped with a spit rapid, like a rat to the hat, but I'll aim at Tenno. Pin fire, bitch, I could out rap Reno. A patent pedal be great, but a nap, you know. He can out rap Reynolds. I think that's more over like Reynolds. From how much I know about is within India, it's a pen company, so it's used to write lyrics. And I think he kind of may be referencing to that, where he can out-rap Reynolds, and then he gives the example of pen and pad. So maybe it could be that. Let's just listen it again. With a capital P out the back window with a black Cadillac limo, like a whack demo. When I'm strapped with a spit rapid, like a rat to the hat, but I'll aim at Tenno. Pin fire, bitch, I can out-rap Reynolds. A patent pedal be great, but a nap, you know. Yeah, and then also in this line he says that I don't know if a lot of people have watched the documentary where they interview Eminem about his writing pattern, his rapping and lyrics. So he said that he sometimes jots down his lyrics on any piece of paper that he can find. So it's not necessary that he needs a laptop, because I don't think he types his lyrics. But yeah, he said that he can write it in notebooks, sometimes even in napkins or tissue papers. And he had a box where all of these papers were there, where he showed it to the interviewer. So he says the same thing over here, that a pen and pad or maybe even a napkin will do. So he doesn't really need a pen and pad. He can even use a napkin to pen down his lyrics and make an awesome song out of it. Shady's back, it's the bat signal. It's time to go batshit. So I think most of you can understand that reference over there. That is such a heavy chorus. That is a head bogging chorus. I think I need to just replay that a little bit. So hi there, bitch. My name is Martian. My mouth is swirl. S on my chest. Superman. Like it's plural. S on my chest like it's plural. So I think he's trying to say that he's super, superhuman. Like he's not just a Superman. He's a Superman with plural S, with multiple S's on his chest. So that's how insanely awesome he is. Phil Sluggerin, cracked it, I'd like to introduce myself. Hi there, bitch. My name is Martian. My mouth is swirl. It's on my chest. Superman. Like it's plural. Call me extra, extra. Terrestrial. Extra, extra, extra. Terrestrial. Yeah. That's extraterrestrial. It could be that he's extraterrestrial or extra to rest Israel. So maybe it could also be the way he says it in this second part of the chorus, extra to rest Israel. So it just could be a reference. I'm not sure if he's trying to say that, but it could be. If you break down the words, it could sound like extra to rest Israel, maybe.
Extra to rest Israel. Yeah. I could keep beefing. Fuck is the point. I can make it really difficult for motherfuckers to come to Detroit.
So for everybody who knows or maybe doesn't know, Eminem had a beef with Machine Gun Kelly and all the Kill Shot and Rap Devil and those tracks. So Machine Gun Kelly had said that how Eminem can cry like a bitch to Trick. So I think Eminem is trying to address that topic again over here, probably, that if he really wants to beef with someone, he can make it really difficult for them to come to Detroit, which is actually a fact because Eminem is from Detroit. Most of his contacts are from Detroit. He has a good relationship with Trick. There was an interview where Trick explains how he knows Eminem. So I think this is a very, very clean, subtle warning to everybody who's trying to beef with Eminem and make, even Nick Cannon probably, because I think Nick Cannon also said that he will show up at the video shoot of Eminem. So I think this is also targeted at Nick Cannon because it's a subtle way of saying that if I want to beef, I'll make it really difficult for these all people to come to Detroit. Let's continue. I can make it really difficult for motherfuckers to come to Detroit. If you're still looking for smoke, I already gave you an L. I'd rather just see you in hell, but I should get puff on a joint. So if there are any battle rap fans watching this, give you an L is like defeating in a rap battle or destroying someone. And then the other reference over here is I should get puff on the joint. So this is again a Machine Gun Kelly reference because in Kill Shot also Eminem mentioned Diddy. So puff on the joint is for Puff Diddy. Or Diddy. So I think he's again referencing them. I should get puff on the joint, Diddy. Yeah. I already gave you hell. I'd rather just see you in hell. But I should get puff on the joint. Diddy. Wait, run it back. I said give you an L. And hell, puff on the joint. I am the blunt you avoid. That flow is phenomenal. But I stopped it because I don't know how many King of the Dot fans are watching this, but if you have ever watched Conceited in battle rap, this run it back scheme, I think I have heard Conceited use it. Let's run it back, where he changes. I think it starts like this. Hold on, I just dissed you, and then he runs it back, and then he explains how what he was actually saying was a diss and not a compliment. I think over here Eminem is trying to target Conceited because in the diss track to Eminem that was made by Nick Cannon, they had also featured Conceited. So maybe this is a reference to Conceited. But what is really awesome about this is how Eminem switched it and made it fit into a track. It's the flow is phenomenal over here. Let's just listen it again. Run it back, I said give you an L. And hell, puff on the joint, I am the blunt you avoid. Used to get jumped for my points. When I was growing up, they said a slinky's a wonderful toy. Used to get jumped for my poems. I think he said poems. So Eminem has said in his interview how he used to get bullied in school and how bigger kids would pick on him. So I think he's referencing how he would get picked on for his poems. Poems would be his raps or his lyrics because he started writing in school. So that's a reference over there to that part. And then Slinky, such a wonderful toy. He said that, right? I am the blunt you avoid. Used to get jumped for my points. When I was growing up, they said a slinky's a wonderful toy. My mother right. Thought I was such a fun little boy. Yo, what a bundle of joy. Until the morning, she suffered a punch in the groin from a tantrum I was throwing. So, Slinky, such a wonderful toy. This is an example of saying that kid who used to write those poems or those raps, he basically had nothing for him. Even Slinky was a huge thing because for somebody who has nothing, even a small matchbox could be a car or a spaceship. I think if if there are people who can relate to this, I think you and me, we all know what that reference was. And then it's good to see Eminem referencing his mother again with the kick in the groin, or I think the punch in the groin, he said. It's good that he's bringing the old Slim Shady back. So this is something that Slim Shady used to do, reference Kim, reference his mother, give examples of how he loved his daughter. And the way he fitted into that lyric was really nice. And I think this is more of a Slim Shady track. This is not an Eminem track. And since Kamikaze, it's more of Slim Shady and less of Eminem. Let's just listen. Little boy, I want a bundle of joy. Until the morning, she suffered a punch in the groin. From a tantrum, I was throwing like a motherfucking disgruntled employee. I don't cut the beat till I fucking destroy it. Once I get going, rain, thunder, and stormy puddles are forming. I hear somebody's voice. In my head, say it's still a dream. Then he said, kill him, C's. Chippy Red with pills and lean. Kill MCs. So he's saying how he hears voices that tell him to kill MCs. And then he also mentioned another rapper over here, which is a triple red or triple dead, someone who has like tattoos and all on his face. I haven't heard that guy, but I had seen his face in a meme that appeared on social media, so I know the name triple dead or triple read something. And then he references Lean, so it's the same line of mumble rappers and artists that are following and copying Lil Wayne, tattoos on their faces and promoting drugs and lean. It's a good bar. Trippy Red. That's the artist, Trippy Red. Getting head, guillotine. I know most of you will be knowing what getting head means, but he's also saying about decapitation, about how getting ahead, guillotine. With pills and lean, sipping meds in a limousine, getting head, guillotine. My name's Marsh, I'm out of this world, swirl, it's so much, yeah, Superman, like it's plural, extra, extra, terrestrial, extra, 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 terrestrial, yeah. So all of y'all can just suck a penis, suck a penis. I'll do the opposite, eat your pussies like cunnilingus, like... I think most of you know what sucking a penis is. In case you don't know, maybe you can look it up. But then I'm sure not a lot of you know what cunnilingus is. But then again, my advice would be to look that up too. It's better you find it out for yourself. Only if you are above 18, that would be my suggestion. Let's just run it back. So all of y'all can just suck a penis, suck a penis. I'll do the opposite, I'll do the, eat your pussies like cunnilingus, like cunnilingus. There ain't no stopping it, there ain't no stopping it. They say I'm such a genius, I'm such a genius. When that kamikaze hit, kamikaze, now they call me Butterfingers, cause I just keep dropping shit. You want a butt head, shut up, Beavis. This is dropping shit, Butterhead and Beavers. Butthead and Beavers. There was a cartoon, I think, which is named as Butthead and Beavers. I don't know any more details. I have never watched the cartoon, but I have seen this going on Facebook since the album released, a photograph of Butthead and Beavers. So I think this is a reference to that. Let's just listen. They call me Butterfingers, because I just keep dropping shit. Dropping shit like Butterfingers. So I think this could be a reference to Butthead and Beavers. You want a butthead? Shut up, Beavers. Beavers. I got your bitch with a butt out. I'm hitting the lick cause she's sticking her tongue out. You got no hitters. You might be pitching a shutout. You got no hitters. You might be pitching the shutout. I think that's self-explanatory. She about to give up the dugout. I should just live in a nut house. Right now I live in an igloo. Yeah. I should just live in a nut house. She about to give up the dugout. I should just live in a nut house. Right now I live in an igloo, yeah. And I'm not chilling the fuck out. Right now I live in an igloo, but I am not chilling the fuck out. So if you're living in an igloo, most probably you're already cold and chilly. But since it's Eminem, he's living in an igloo, he still is not chilling the fuck out. I should just live in a nut house. Right now I live in an igloo, yeah. And I'm not chilling the fuck out. Treat you like a step parent does to a stepchild with red hair, and plus I get dough like Ed Sheeran, so call me the gingerbread man. Is a reference about how probably his father treated him, because we all know that his stepfather wasn't there for him, didn't treat him well, and he also made a song about how he used to beat him up and everything. And the other reference is to Ed Sheeran's Gingerbread Man.
Just to a stepchild with red hair, plus I get dough like Ed Sheeran, so call me the Gingerbread Man. I'm a stan of Redman, X-Clan, and I'm a Tretch fan, but I look up to myself like a fucking headstand.
I think a lot of people need to understand this how important this line was. I'm a stan of Redman. Here you can see how an artist like Eminem, such a huge artist, platinum artist, is sending props to other artists. It's respect. And surprisingly, we don't have this within artists that are coming up these days. People are not really sharing each other's work or giving respect to each other, being humble. And this is a good example of how he's giving props to Redman. And we had heard this, I think, in one of the interviews of Eminem where he said that he's a fan of Redman. This is a really, really nice, humble line to put it out there in a track. And then he also says, I look up to myself like a headstand. So I look up to myself like a headstand. Yeah, so if you will be in a headstand, if you will be in a headstand, your hands will be on the floor, your body will be up towards the sky, and you will want to look up to yourself, like you will want to look at yourself. If you want to just see yourself, you will have to look up. So this is really smart and clever about using the headstand in a lyric. I think I've not heard that before in any of the hip hop or rap tracks before, so this is really smart and clever. This track is really awesome.
X-Clan and I'm a Tretch fan, but I look up to myself like a fucking headstand. So why else but I call myself an alien? How could I hit a dry spell? Yeah. I'm named after the wetlands. I'm Martian, I'm out of this world.
Obviously, if he's named after a wetland, or if he's Martian, he can't have a dry spell. And then if he's Eminem, he can't really have a dry spell.
Hit a dry spell. Yeah. I'm named after the wetlands. I'm Martian. I'm out of this world. This world is so much as Superman. Like it's plural.
Call me extra, extra.
So that's real. My name is Martian. My name is Marsh.
All right, guys. That's my explanation of the track. I think it's an awesome track. I like the music. I like Eminem's flow on it, especially the way he flipped Conceited's flow on the Run It Back line. I really love the track. The music is on point. I think this can be played in clubs. This should be played on the radio. But then, this could be like one of my favorite tracks for this year, because I haven't heard a lot of music in this year since it just started, but this is probably going to be one of my most favorite tracks. And in case you guys like what you heard, you have some suggestions, in case I missed catching a bar somewhere, please don't hesitate to put it in the comments. I tried my best, and if you have some other suggestions, I'll be uploading more stuff. I'll try to break down lyrics from more tracks from other artists also. So let's just continue with it. See you next time. Peace. Good night.